that soon. I'm going to be cutting it and lighting it soon. Now this goes for $11.74. This is more than I usually pay. But I like this brand enough that every now and then I'll break down and I'll get one. You know? So right here we're looking at 6.25x54. And this is a Connecticut broadleaf wrapper, I believe, with Indonesian binder or something like that. I'll stop by saying that. I'm going to cut it and I'm going to light it now.
Success is the greatest enemy.
Are you
going
to get in here?
How are you doing, brother? Not too bad. How's it been?
It smells like a sweet chocolate raisinette kind of feel.
What'd you do?
Oh, sorry. A little bit of mustiness, a foot smell maybe.
Get organized. A little bit of Robustos and Irish whiskeys and some rums.
Very good. Off of that, it's a little hot right here to do this.
What's this?
Oh, Illinois. What part of Illinois?
There's a bun cap right here. They do have one of those.
Okay. So that's further west than Elgin.
I actually use this because that on the cutter I don't really do.
Okay. I grew up in St. Louis, Granite City, Illinois.
Yes, I did. I broke down and got something like that.
Yeah, I did. Oh, no kidding.
Pre-light drawer is nice, very smooth. I can tell this is going to be good.
Got 18.
Very nice. A little bit of Applejacks.
You could grab two more freebies.
Yeah,
and
nice.
You could just go do anything you want. We'll just take off. Yeah. Two of the more expensive ones you've got there. Which
God, I think the light is over here, if I'm not mistaken. It's a closed foot also. I did not feature that it is a closed foot. A little bit of a long stat, but I'm going to do it where I paid it off for it. I'm going to feature it good and I'll illustrate how this is. Right here. It's got a very nice pre-light taste to it. Very nice. Very smooth, a little bit. Like an Applejack's taste to it, for sure. And hay, a little bit of hay. Very nice, very fine. So let's toast this thing. It's closed foot right there. You look real closely. Break on hiatus for a bit. I don't know. But very nice stuff. Very smooth.
You good?
I am. Alright. So I taste a little bit of maybe slight leather. Cologne, nuts, a little earth,
Thanks.
All right, so, it tastes a heavy nutty taste in this cigar. It's a good cigar. It's pretty decent, I think. Yeah, very good taste. Very good. It's like usually a cigar of this profile. If another maker would make it, it would usually taste more harsh, I would say. But these usually have a smooth finish to them, which even if they're of a high strength, they don't feel as bad. You know? And that's the smoothness of the tobacco here. Like some cigars with this profile would probably be kicking you right off the bat. They would probably be... the tip would be more moistened, I think, very fast. I'll tell you that. And let's see how this rolls. Let's see how this smokes with the temperature not being the coolest it did. Let's see if this stays dry. Let's see if it actually stays dry. That's a good indicator for me. Conversation about places. I'm going to be traveling soon again, so alright. What I don't see here right off the bat, I see a little oil, but I don't see like an oil ring like you would kind of expect. That's what I don't see right now. All right. The cigar shop that I'm in, they move a little down the hall here in the plaza, I guess you could say, and this is the new location. I like the old location too. I thought it was cozy, actually. I liked it. It's good. This is just newer though. Like they had a smell in the air. It smelled kind of like millet, maybe, or oatmeal. But it wasn't bad though. Kind of classic. They moved it over here though. But yeah, the air had like a millet oatmeal kind of smell. Now it tastes like a nice, sweet, nutty cigar. It tastes like a slight cologne. I want to give this a shot today. I've been eyeing it for a while, so. So far, it's remaining more dry. You can tell the difference with this leaf, usually. You can. But they talk a lot about Davidoff, but I don't think Kristoff's where it's at, honestly. You get some Davidoff seconds, they can be good. If they put an alternate name on them or something. I have found Davidoff cigars to be very good. But as far as paying that $18, $20 premium for them, I would say not to do it. Honestly. Retrohale is nice. It's like a finer, peppery kind of feel. It's not 100% black pepper, but it's like a finer spice with some pepper in it, maybe. Little ginger. Tastes a little ginger in here. Now I got a mouthful of saliva, right? But I swallowed it, no problem. Usually I try to spit. So I'm comparing the tobacco here. This is a finer tobacco. I don't feel as lousy when I have it lingering in my mouth. At least thus far, I don't. But on some other cigars, I have. I'm not even reaching for my water a lot. I think that indicates the smooth tobacco leaf on here, probably, if I had to guess. Burn pretty even, tiny bit wavy, but even for the most part. taste a little bit of potato skin, earth. There's a mirage of flavors in there right now. Silvery ash right up here, so they're showing there is a silvery ash. That's good. To put a nice wrap on it with predominantly the wrapper, even in a more thicker side. This is good. This has a nice decent wrap on it here. There's something that's like 52 or 54 ring gauge. It's got a good wrap on it, for sure. See if that's still the case. Is it smoking? If I'll need to grab a water right away. Or if I... In that case, I'm glad I paid extra for the cigar. Because with the temperature in here, if this actually holds me through, that'll be more worth it for me, actually. You know? No, it's not. It's a different place. It's different. I was at, Ted's. I'm here now, though. What's that here? It's actually a new renovated cigar bar right here. They moved it from, like, down the hall from where it used to be. And I like the old shop, too, but they made it more modern here. It's not as, you know, the air doesn't smell like millet and oatmeal as much, if that makes sense. And they roll their own. They have their own roll here and stuff. And then they got others like this right here that I chose. Today I chose this one. It's a Kristoff Vengeance. The way this tobacco, yeah, it is. That's the bathroom, one of them. Yeah. Well, you know, peace came out of this. Yeah, it's like a $12 cigar right here, Dan. I got a $12 stick right here today. If this ends up being smoother, like I said, it's better with the temperature in here. Not being as cool as it could be. And then it'll hold me a little more. So, like, another way to judge it, at least... Now, I'm not 100% positive on this, but in my time smoking, I've learned that this is a fine leaf, okay? It's a fine leaf of tobacco here. Yeah. $12 cigar, yeah, $12 cigar. And when I have the saliva lingering in my mouth, I usually rush to get a drink of water. But in this case, I was able to swallow it a little easier. So give or take, you know, I guess. Surprised I'm not going for my water as much, actually. But then again, maybe not. This happened last time I spoke to Kristoff, too. I didn't have to really rush to get a drink or anything. So let's move. Anything else with this profile, this exact profile, wouldn't have tasted as good, really. But it's very good because of the leaf and because of the quality. Even if it ordinarily wouldn't be my favorite profile, the fact that this is made nice makes it taste very good, though. And this is actually a Connecticut broadleaf.
What? How you doing, bud?
Yeah, nice people, yeah. Yeah, go back in the video, you'll see. I was using a lighter or whatever, yeah. Pretty much in all of them they are, though, too.
How's the man doing?
You know what I ate before coming here? I got a tamale, actually. And I got like three different sauces. I got like a pico de gallo. And I got that. $2.74, right? I mean, they give you a tamale or whatever. Yeah, both sides are corrupt, really. Very good. You see that nice silveriness in here too? Yeah, I haven't even rushed to get my drink of water. It's almost like I'm drinking kind of like a black coffee with the tobacco remains in my mouth or something. Which isn't really great, but it's better than if you have, like, the moistened tobacco oils in your mouth with some brands, you know. It tastes more finer when you have, like, the residue, is what I'm saying. Feels good in here now. Retrohale's spicy. Not overwhelmingly, but it's spicy with like a nice nutty taste. And some other spices, maybe a little bit of, I don't know. Can't fully identify them, but they're smooth. Maybe a tiny bit of cinnamon, maybe. Cinnamon and maybe white pepper. I'd like to say white pepper and cinnamon, maybe. I don't know. Yeah, white pepper and cinnamon. There's no pungent citrus taste in here coating the whole thing. Or anything like that. Basically a nutty, slightly chocolatey profile. Some coffee grounds. But smoother than that, actually. More like a cream coffee and coffee grounds. Combination, baby. Yeah. Really good. I would, but probably not for a while because they got other ones, and at this price point, you know, you want to try them, you know, for sure. Anything they get's really good. Anything they make is good, rather. They used to sell their Cristanias at certain liquor stores, and some places had them, I know. They were paying like up to maybe $7 or $8 for a large, like 7x70 or something. And that was decent, they put it out. Every once in a while, you can find these at a lower price. Not anymore, though. But once in a while. There might have been 8 or 9, maybe. I'm smoking the Kristoff Vengeance. It's in the title. But it's such a smooth tobacco leaf that I really don't have to be taking a drink very often. If that makes sense. And I just have water. Pretty fine ash. Hit me in my stomach, kind of. And this is dry. Nothing so hardcore about it that would moisten it up really bad or anything. It's a great smoke output right here. Very good. I did one last night too on a Vanilla Delight. If you saw that one, you weren't in here, any of you. You weren't in here for it. That was just a $2 cigar, and that was good. Really just depends. Sometimes you go into like a takeout shop and you get like this $2 to $3 cigar that's been aged. Then you have it, it's like really good. It's like, wow. Sometimes I like to get surprises like that, you know. Slightly isn't, but it's a good cigar. Just seeing what I'm trying to see before I go, you know, trying to see everything. And still that nice cinnamon white pepper retrohale with the nuttiness, like almond and chocolate and cream coffee. No earth. No major flavor changes, but the ones that are here are very good and they're not getting worse. I'll say that. Even with the cigar getting a little bit of heat on it. The drawer improves sometimes. And now that might burn off right there. Get another pack of matches. excuse me for the shake here. Roughly about, I think, 33 minutes in, technically. Actually. Oh, a nice oil right here. Oh, a nice oil right there for me. Usually if I'm shaking, that isn't a good sign. Usually. But in this case, I feel better. Just burning nice. You get what you pay for with these. In my humble opinion, you do get what you pay for with these. I'm gonna rest it again. Because I don't wanna make it too hot. And the lingering tobacco oil in the mouth here. Swallow it with less problem. Actually, I'm up with my elbows. I'm shaky, I'll try this side. Yeah, not as much. When I hold it with this hand, see that? Now I'm gonna hold it with this one here. That's where the oil was, right there. Where that burn is. Made the ash black. Pretty much going all the way around. Someone's in trouble. Ambulance. Look at that silver though. That silver is good. That's what you gotta have. You want to keep smoking it until it gets like really hot. Hey, Dan. I had a Red Baron pizza last night. I'll tell you, for microwavable pizza, that's the best stuff. And I'll say it over and over again, too. Supreme pizzas and stuff. They come in the box, you know, two of them. More oil for me. Right there. See the oil? Hold on 1 second. All right, I'm back. I did a little quick TikTok. Nice overall flavors, and it's going down. It's getting even more hotter and everything like that. It's going down, getting a little hotter. And the taste is still good. Even if it doesn't burn perfectly all the way around sometimes, the quality makes up for that. Still dry. Even with a little bit increase in moisture, it's still dry. That's also what to look for. There's like no pungent flavors to make it saliva badly where it's so wet. Which some cigars do to me, depending on what they are. Even some in the $6 range do that. In the $7. You get what you pay for with these. And I'll say it again. Whenever I have them, I enjoy them quite well. I did a pissed off Kristoff review sometime back in Florida. I think it is on this channel. Game 3 tonight, I think. With the Celtics and Warriors. I think so. Or it's tomorrow, if it isn't. It might be tomorrow. A little uneven there. Drop. rolls a bit of an ash, then it drops all of a sudden on you. Whole thing's pretty much warmed up. It's not cool anymore, really. It's hot up at the band right there. And there's oil coming down the shaft here. It's oil right there. On the shaft, so yeah. Burn line. So even at this price you can do that sometimes, depending. Actually, it was in California where someone taught me a trick. Even here and there, but it's just right here that isn't. So I'm gonna have to touch that up with the match. Awesome smoke up. It's crying a little bit. I'll just rest it. Little sun coming in from the back here. Yeah. Feel the oil a little more now. Yeah, I might have to touch that up soon. Light dab on it. It's actually trying now to burn. Flaky a little bit. A little bit of that dropped. Thank you. definitely need to touch up. Off pretty good. It's trying to get perfect now. Silveriness is back. White draw. Retrohale, the same flavor. Same flavors. It's pretty much the same flavors throughout. They're sticking, they're good. Now it's perfectly even. It didn't take much. It's now perfect. Silver on the outside of the wrapper, the dock is the binder right there on the ash. Again, I believe it's an Indonesian binder. With a Connecticut broadleaf Maduro wrapper. Another country. There might be even Honduran in here too. There's three. There's actually three countries in here. It's Verta Perfect. rest of it. Right on. Okay. Yeah, what they do have for cigar bars in Nebraska are nice ones. Just like there's some nice sit-in restaurants, too. We're talking like, remember? If anyone remembers the movie Problem Child, right? When they were at Pizzerific? That's the kind of restaurants that are actually present around here. Sometimes even pizza buffet places, too. Like one for kids, it isn't a Chuck E. Cheese, it's actually based out of here. But it's like a Chuck E. Cheese, but with like better food. It's just a kiddie place. So. So right there, burning relatively even. And now I'm gonna even it out. Look at that. Looks like it's evening itself. See the smoke go up. Smoke going up into the air, so. So pretty much the Punch, Fu Manchu, and this, and the rest of them are going to be the no-name ones from here that I get, if any of them. Unless I want that other Kristoff, I don't know. But they got some good handmade ones here. And a limited selection of the ones with the bands like these. But they got these. Of illusions too. To me, those aren't worth it at a high price. They're okay though. They're not bad. You pay a few bucks more for this, you know. So. Even some of the handmades here go up to $9. Where you get more tobacco than this, but this is, I would say, a more enjoyable smoke, honestly. They're better here with their smaller cigars. For like six or something. Yeah, an hour in. I had a cigar last night, a little flavored cigar. It lasted me almost an hour. Catch that review when you get a chance. It's last night I did it. Doing my cigar shopping right now.
How are you?
After a while of not, I'm doing it now, kind of. Because I might go on hiatus. I probably won't be in cigar bars, at least at the very start when I go or go. So while I have an experience here, I'll get it all out here while I'm here. stay tuned. I might review a when I go out for barbecue. I'll probably put that on my main channel there. Canoeing off a little, but it looks like it could correct itself. Not tonight. Maybe tomorrow, or maybe the next day. I don't know. Then I'm going to go somewhere else before I leave. See, I keep the adventure going, or at least I try. Wednesday. This is new. They just moved over here, like down the same plaza, but they moved to a different location here. What? Who the fuck is that? There's Skandar Ragbag. He was in the WWE. I remember a long time ago. Wrestling. Toward the end, it just gave me a little more trouble with the bird. That's probably my only complaint. Other than that, it's been fine. Very good. Move from the end right here.
It's going to be very safe.
I didn't watch Star Wars, so I don't know. That wasn't really my thing growing up. You know, the Jedi, I know Darth Vader and Luke, but by name. Oh wow, velvety smoke coming out of here, blowing it up. That's velvet. Nice, thick, white smoke coming out of it. No, I was little. I just wasn't into it, really. I liked Spaceballs more with Rick Moranis, stuff. I did like that more. I watched that. And I watched Little Shop of Horrors. That's the stuff I love. Steve Martin. Yeah. Looks like that's trying to burn off right there, though. A little bit. But hiking up a little bit too at the same time. Burning off slowly, kind of that spot right there. Yeah, See, you got silver on that side. Real good silver right there. Ash still on pretty hot though, so I'll drop it right away. An hour and 7. Good. More like an hour and 4. Because I started it 3 minutes in, I was trying to light it. Oh, I might be in lock right there. Let's see. Flavor profile is the same. It's like a cinnamon white pepper retro ale. And an overall nutty taste. Same flavor profile. Chocolate and coffee. Tastes very good even right now, so I'm gonna put it down. Go to the bathroom. Yeah, this one. smoke output. Very good. The ash about to drop. It will, this will drop too. All right, there it is. All right. Look at that. And there's that right there. Some silver. Burn it off. Okay. You found cigar leaf tobacco? Well, that's what I do. I take the scraps and I mix them for pipe. I still got the pipe here. I still got some of them. Believe it or not, I still got some of them. I just don't use it. Probably unless I ran out of cigars or something. I haven't smoked it in a while. There it is, it's trying to. Okay. Burned off. Look a bit, but it did burn off. Yeah, totally now. Silver still on there. I mean, it's holding up good, I think. Oh, Gerbil. What the fuck? Give it a rest. I'm satisfied for that. A little oil right there. Good with the oil. Hey. Hey Dan, I think George would be impressed if he came in here. He never made his like this. He probably should have, as it's like the only one in the area, really. I bet he could. He probably just doesn't want it, I'm thinking. You know why, Dan? I know he's got the budget. I think he's just frugal is what it is, Dan. Kind of like a lot of people. Well, he's definitely what I would call a reputable business. He's definitely a legit business. He's been around many years. Oh, he could. He could get it done. Like the one I was at yesterday, too. Even something like that. So you've got a few like this. You got maybe about, there's obviously, there's about three that I know of in the immediate area, like, kind of like this. I'd say. Now this one that's new, another one, and then the other one yesterday. Then the rest are pretty much carry out tobacco with like cheaper beers and stuff, or six packs of beers or whatever. They're a little less money. I'd say higher than Tobacco Haven, though, for those. There's different states, they have different prices and stuff. rest that. Yeah, it is. Portland had a place like that too, though. Dan. I used to go there and carry out, buy, and bring it back. But Portland had a place with like budget cigars and other ones that are more money. And they also had a lot of beer, and a lot of beer, actually. They called that one Tobacco Town. It was like, one of them was like, looked like an old arcade building or something. Like very 80s looking. Lots of beer. And then budget smokes too, cigars, cigarettes. Everywhere started making you wear your mask. It was just, they did the social distancing thing and all that, plus a mask. No, there really isn't. I think Tewksbury's got one, but I'd say George is the number one. I'd say he could be the number one, even right now, over there. Imagine if he expanded, though. Other than that, you got, what do you got, New Hampshire, and then you got Middleton. That's really about it. I know Middleton has one. It's expensive as shit, though. The cigar bar they got in Middleton. I drove by there. I checked it up. I went to Richardson's or something that day. And I got a Richardson's frap instead of a cigar that day. I remember I drove in that direction. I decided to just go to Richardson's. Because they were too high priced in the cigar shop. But yeah, otherwise it's two guys in New Hampshire, and it's pretty much everything in Nashua and Salem. And in Manchester, if you want to drive, they got a few. Castro's, they got them in Nashua, Concord. I went to the one in Concord too once, maybe two times. I think once though. What is that? No, but really not. There was one time I wore a mask. I'm trying to think of when it was where I willingly put on a mask. It's when I was deathly sick. That's what happened. It's when I was real for shit. Fuck. Drop the bomb. Damn it. God. Kind of messy this one is. Toro right there. With the tax, $12.91. So it's about a dollar something tax. It's less than mass, but not by much. I would say here. Maybe sometimes the same, actually, sometimes, depending on where you, this is one place that's more money than a place than I think Middleton, and it's in Omaha, it's more money, I think, than the one in Middleton. It's on the west side, I don't go there, though. I went in there once, and a $2 to $3 cigar went for $6, that was like the cheapest one they had. I wouldn't pay $6 for that thing. I knew what it was too. I smoked it before somewhere else. I wouldn't pay $6 for it though, I'll tell you that. So this is one of the better deals if you're gonna pay. Kristoff's one of the best cigars, so And it's still going at this point, and it dropped on the floor too, and it stayed together. I mean, the leaf still stayed together. People will go from Mass to National Road. The rest is open. Well, some people might. Depends on their other expenses, I guess, in Mass. Look at the property taxes or less, maybe. Then they go up there, they save money. That's how they see it, though. But then they bulk buy, so they're really spending a lot of money anyway. Kind of thing. That's the general idea, but I don't think you really do, even if you live in Mass and go there. Unless you're buying a bunch, but even when you buy a bunch, you're still spending more money either way. If I think if you're an alcoholic, it's good, yeah. You want a bar or something in your basement, maybe. But you're still spending a lot for that, though, too. That's the thing. TVs that you save a lot of money on there, but add it all up, though. Add it all up with the liquor, the TVs, the... whatever else you're buying up there, bringing it back. You'd spend way less getting it in Mass if you got lesser amounts, ultimately. Even if you got that TV, but you buy less alcohol, say. Let's just say that. Dropped again. Fuck. Very slippery. I mean, that's part of the fineness of it, man. It's just too slippery. Still in there. An hour and 26. Lasts a long time. Sometimes for that one you get that's around 12, you could get two, say, and smoke them, and we would add up to more money. That one is satisfying enough right there. When you look at it like that, then you don't really spend, you might spend less for this, really, if you buy two that are over $6, say. And they're not as good as this, but they're good, but they're not as good as this, maybe. You know, in some ways, you see why I do get the bargain sticks, right? In some ways, you do. There are some that are around $6 or $7. They're good, but sometimes I find better ones than the cheaper ones, actually. At least flavor-wise. Well, I don't know. Nice to dream, right? Hey, but it's a roll of the dice there. But it's one that I gotta take. Just the fact the idea is heavily floating around means something, even though I haven't done it. People aren't really even laughing at it and making it sound like a joke. There are literally people who said I should be there. In the past, too, when I wouldn't listen. grout, it still isn't 100% hot in my fingers, but yet it was getting hot as I smoked it before. It has gone back to a cool smoke of some kind. It's going to get hot inevitably, but it's holding, and it dropped twice. I mean, that was a good buy, in essence. Save that for dropping a third time. Losing its light a little bit. That doesn't feel really hot either. They make these good. They make them last. Some of them will be burning me. Even if it's about to, it still lasts. I mean, crap. Now it's smoking like crazy. Look at this. Look at that. Look at that right there. Tell me that's not a good smoke, huh? It's up there with Davidoff in quality. They're better, actually, I think, than Davidoff. Which are like $20 cigars. I've had enough Davidoff to know that they're better when you get the knockoff Davidoff for less than money. They have seconds or thirds or whatever under another name, but they produce them. And they're like in you know the Smoking Joe cigars, Dan? The Smoking Joes up at IOTS? Those are Davidoff made, and they're like $4 and something. Maybe they're $4.99 now. So they make more of those that are less. So in that case, why spend $20? Is what it comes down to. Well, Kristoff doesn't make any like that. They stay cheaper than Davidoff, so. I got a question for you, Dan. You mentioned Magic Johnson, right? But do you like, as a person or a football player, both maybe? I don't know if you watch football. Herschel Walker. Do you like Herschel Walker at all by chance? Because now he's getting in the political arena. Okay. He's a Republican, though. But yeah. But I saw, like, him and his son and stuff. I actually caught a little bit of... I happened to see a Herschel Walker video with his son or something. Or his son does ballet. Herschel Walker, I guess, did ballet when he was young. Sometimes when you look really deep into somebody, like, you know, like, you find out things. It's kind of funny. And he accepts his son how he is. And I think maybe I was meant to see that when my father has trouble accepting me. You know, Herschel Walker is good with this sun, it turns out. And his son's like gay, practically. Maybe trans. So that kind of resonated with me, actually. The cigar is finished. This is what's left of it right here. It's done at this point. I'm through. It lost its light, but look at how long it lasted, for Christ's sake. Look at that. And that ash looks good still. Can't complain. Anything else you want to say here about Herschel or anything? Yeah. Let's talk afterwards. How about that? Alright, I'm gonna go. Bye. On behalf of the Kristoff Vengeance Toro. Connecticut Broadleaf. Signing out. Bye.